In this episode of Finno-Greek Machining, well, we are going to make a gasoline faucet. That's a very strange word for me. Yeah, gasoline cut of a valve for our lawnmower. Well, we bought a new lawnmower 1 year ago. And now this one doesn't have a cutoff valve for gasoline. It relies on the there is a buoyant thing inside the carburettor, which is then cutting off the fuel if there is too much of it. And now it looks like this leaks a little bit. And it had leaked oil into the carburetor and then furthermore into the oil. Well, that's bad news for the motor. Well, of course I need to change the oil, but before I do that I will make a cut-off valve for the for that one, so we can cut off the fuel. Well, you could buy these under 10 euros. But what's the fun in that? And you have to wait. And well, the quality is... I don't know what the quality is. But when I do it myself, well, I get what I get. At least I know what it is. So, the first time ever I have a documentation for this one. I will put pictures of these at the end of this video, if you want to make such a valve, which I doubt. But, so let's start with the body of that one. Well, the body of this valve is made out of, 16 millimeter cold rolled mild steel. There you are. Not straight. So yeah, I'm using this 16 millimeter collet chuck this time. And now this piece should be, first of all faced at both ends. At one end first, then the other end measured, and then I will turn it to the correct dimension. Ready now. Wow. Well, no, not ready. Next operation will be done in the milling machine. Now the workpiece is in the milling vise. This clamp here is pushing down this jaw, which has... This is a very flimsy vise, and I don't want this jaw to lift up.
because it would actually make this part to be out of place. But now, let's position this correctly. So first I want to touch this here. Let's see if I can do it easily. I should be able to do that. Yeah. Okay. Away from this jaw, so I need to move that way, half of the diameter of that minus 3, and it's 5 millimeters, seems 8 minus 3 is 5, so 5, so that's 4 and 5. There you are. And yeah, I looks like correct. Yeah, I actually I took the backslash in account here. So now Y is locked, and now this is 15 millimeters long, and I would like it to be in the middle of that. So first we move 3 millimeters like that. That was 3 millimeters. Now the center of this thing is exactly on the edge of that workpiece. And now 15 divided by 2 is 7.5. 7.5 millimeters. So that was 4, 5, 6, 7, and then 5. There. And block the axe as well. And it looks like being in the middle. Let's start with this one. I lubricate that one on the top of the flutes, so I let the oil drain down, and I will feed this real high. We are through. Oh my. Okay. 5 millimeter. Hold. And now let's change the drill. I will be step drilling this because, well, yeah, and I have a problem. Namely, I don't have I don't have a 7 millimeter reamer. So I need to. Okay, and now these are no more needed, so I put them away. So I first drill a 6.5 millimeter hole. to low gear. When I make the piece that goes into that hole, it should be quite accurate. Actually, drawing calls for the hole 7 millimeters plus 200s minus nothing. So, yeah, it should be. But now it becomes probably more than 200s larger than needed. So, well. I think I need to when I do the part that goes into that hole, I need to match it with that hole. So here we go. Not with this speed. That speed. Part is now ready, actually. All we need to do here now is to deburr it. It has a lot of burr in it. Well, 3 millimeter recess on each side, as was in the picture. And yeah, hole through, and well, what not. Well, this next part, well, the total length will be, well, 32 millimeters. But I need to hold it somewhere. When I have finished the part, there will be a radius milling to be done. And that one can be, if I make it 32 millimeters long and then I try to radius mill something there, there will be work holding issues. So I add something, and not just something, quite a lot to that. I will take this 100 millimeters. Well, there will be a lot of material like lost, but I can always use that material for something. This is not going to be wasted. So again, here we go. Yeah, 16 millimeters cold rolled mild steel. There you go. Let's do a little bit of a cleaning here now, just to get rid of all this stuff here. Wow. That was easy enough, but we still have here like a lot of extra stuff hiding behind. I really would like to take this. This is ready to go with this one. Well, not yet. A little bit cleaning the ways. Okay. Now we are starting to turn this thing. So that was the end I deburred, and it goes there really smoothly like that. Should be 99.95. We shall see whether it is or not. Please measure. Well, 99.94 actually. Now it should be 7.5 millimeters. Well, it's not exactly hot, but it's really warm. Really warm. Yeah, 7.5 millimeters here. Well, it's not. And now it's always a good thing practice to check this. It's 7.43. Now that's what that one should be, 7.03 or something like that. We shall see. 7.03, yeah. Well, it's 7.04. Okay, I can deal with 7.04. That's a bit, little bit too much to file. I'll check it with this one now, though, whether it fits in there. Not a chance. So I can take 200ths away from it. This is one of the benefits of that tool. You can really peel off a few hundredths with that one. Should be. We already made there a small chamfer, and now I will put this there. Well, a little bit forward with this one. Now let's put it there. Then like that. I think we are good to go, just a little bit cutting oil there. And then I make the thread. Oh, back here. And turn the lathe off. I don't want any accidents here to happen. This is really easy to turn. Goes like into butter. That's it. Do we want to have more? Maybe a little bit. To take some of this burr away from there. Yeah, that should be it. Let's try it out with one nut in five. Yeah, there you are. It's very good. Yeah. Now the next operation is to make something we need to have here. We need to have something to turn your fingers with, and therefore this is a milling task, and that's exactly the reason why I left so much here so that I can attach it from this end to the vise and then mill here. Well, this here is a 15 millimeter round nose end mill, and the workpiece itself is as securely as I could put it into the vise. And then I have a stopper here because I need to turn it around and 180 degrees and mill a similar slot to the other side as well. So it will be 7 millimeters deep. This is mild steel. Let's see about the speed now. A little bit faster, I believe. Now it's about 200 revolutions per minute. And then I would like to touch it. Yeah, now it touches. And I would like to take only 3 millimeters per pass. So this will get me 3.5 millimeters maybe. No, 3. Let's see, first 3. That was 1.5. That's 3. And then I don't know whether we need cutting oil. Probably yes. Let's see now. This is now 3 millimeter cut. Oh, let me bring you nearer to the action. Yeah. Surface is super. Okay, now we need to take this apart, away from, cut it from somewhere there, and then we should be finished with this one. Let's see. Okay, well, this is how my faucet now looks like. Well, I made this knob, parted it off by a hacksaw, then did some straightening in my bench grinder, and then finally deburred it with Dremel. Well, it's not perfect, not even near perfect, but looks like a practical unit. Well, there is something we need to drill a hole here. Yeah. But that is actually later. Now, the last bit of this puzzle is the little washer here under. It's a little bit special because it will house two O-rings, but yeah, and this is just some piece of 10 millimeter stuck I found in my bin, which I now can put here, and this is the material we are making it of. Oh well, this is 10 millimeter cold rolled mild steel. Seems to be my go-to material nowadays. So, of course, first facing. Okay. Very small piece. This is super small. Okay, I'll take care of that that thing there, and then this is ready. And this also concludes the whole thing. Now I'm drilling a hole to this handle here, and this is well, I do it now because well. First of all, this 3 millimeter tube guides the drill to the correct place. It's very difficult to make a hole in the correct place, but this ensures that it's in the correct place. So let's see the speed. Well, that's mildly set. Wow. Okay, now. Yeah. That should be all right. Then cutting oil. And then, well, yeah. This is a little bit scary operation. Okay. A few times to get rid of possible burr there, and yeah, now that's done. Wow. Okay, well, this small project is now finished. it's probably the smallest one I made, but this is very special. First of all, it's the first project I made in a way that I designed it somehow before I made it. Usually I operate in a way that I work while designing, or design while working, whichever is applicable.
But this time I separated those two processes, and well, actually the result is somewhat better. This is exactly as designed, and it works. The measures, I didn't need to think those in advance. The second thing about this is that, which makes me wonder, this lawn mower doesn't really have a faucet, a petrol cut-off valve. So, if there is any little particles in the fuel, it's very possible when you feel it there in the field that something goes there, they can make the needle valve inside the carburettor such that it leaks gasoline into there. And after that, the next stop for that gasoline is in the oil pan. And that's what happened to our lawnmower. Luckily, we noticed it in time, and it's okay. Well, this faucet is by no means completely tight. It, because of the construction, it's not completely tight. But it doesn't need to be so tight. Now I can close it and wait while the lawnmower runs the carburetor empty. It stops, and after that it takes a considerable amount of time while this is like while the gasoline is seeping through here into there, and it's a really slow process. So yeah, I believe this works just all right. Well, that about concludes this episode of Finno-Greek Machining. In the next one, you never know. Maybe finally the leg for the welding rotating positioner, maybe. But we will see what pops up in the next episode. It always does. So, till then, bye!